Good day, children. Today, we are going to learn a new topic, that is measurement. In today's class, we will be learning the units of length and what are the standard and non-standard units of length, followed by conversion of units of length. At the end of the class, you will be able to identify the units of length and also you will be able to convert meter to centimeter, kilometers to meters, meters to centimeter, or meters to kilometers. So here, let us start to first distinguish between what are the standard units of length and non-standard units of length. So here we go.
Non-standard units of length. A non-standard unit is an unit used for measurement that has no fixed definition in terms of standard units of measure, which means the measurement is indefinite, or the value which we find from the measurement may vary from one to another. We can measure a length with the help of body parts or any object. Examples for non-standard units with body parts and objects. With body parts, we have hand span, cupid, fingers, palm, foot span, etc. With objects, we have pencil, cup, stick, clothes, etc. Now let us see about these examples one by one in detail. Hand span. Hand span is the distance from the tip of the thumb to the little finger. For example, let us measure the length of a table using hand span. So, we are going to measure the length using hand span. The length of this table is about 5 hand spans. Cubit. Cubit is the distance from the tip of the middle finger to the elbow. For example, let us measure a long bamboo stick. So, we are going to measure the long bamboo stick using cubit. Here, the length of this bamboo stick is about 3 cubits. Fingers. It is a unit of distance equal to the width of 4 fingers closely pressed together. So, you can see in the picture, the 4 fingers are closely pressed and that width is called fingers. For example, let us measure the length of a book. So, we are going to measure the length of the book using fingers. So, the length of this book is about 4 fingers. Palm. It is a unit of distance equal to the length of the hand from the wrist to the tip of the middle finger. For example, let us measure the length of a long scale. So, we are going to measure the length of a long scale using palm. Here, the length of this scale is about 3 palms. Foot span. It is a unit of distance based on the length of actual feet. For example, let us measure the length of a room. So, we are going to measure the length of this room using foot span. So, The length of this room is about 20 foot span. Now let us have a look on an example from our textbook page number 47. In how many steps will Dorji cross the road? Now we are going to calculate the length of the road through Dorji's foot span. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Therefore, Dorji will cross the road in 8 steps. And the length of this road is about 8 foot spans. Let us see another example. How many cups can be placed in a line on this table? So, we are going to place the cups in a line and we are going to find how many cups can be placed in a line on this table. Now, we could see 8 cups can be placed on this table. And we shall also say as the length of this table occupies 8 cups. Let us have a look on the next example. How many pots can be placed to reach the tree branch? Now, we are going to place the pots one upon another and calculate the length of the tree till the branch with the pots. So, we could see 6 pots can be placed to reach the tree branch. Similarly, in the next example, we have how many shirts can be hung on this wire. Now, let us hang the shirts in the same way. We could see that 4 shirts can be hung on this given length of wire.
Now, this was very interesting to know what are the non-standard units of length. But just imagine, if we consider hand span or foot span or cubit as the correct form for measuring length? No, right? You may also compare it if I ask you to find the length of any table using your hand span, and then if I ask you, check with the hand span of your parent. Will it be same? No, it's different. So what can be the same answer? What can be the possibility that we will get the actual correct length for both you as well as your parents? Absolutely right. We must have a standard unit of length. So the standard units of length are in terms of meters, centimeters, and kilometers. So here, let us see and learn more about it. We have here conversion from meters to centimeters. So how does it go? Miss Rita's car is 3 meters long. What is the length in centimeters? So think about it. Yes, here we can see her car is 3 meters long and we have to see what would it be in centimeters. We know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So we need to convert from meters to centimeters. We specify this by 3 multiplied by 100. That gives you 300. Therefore, Ms. Rita's car is 300 centimeter long. So in order to change meter to centimeter, we must multiply by 100. Let us see meters and centimeters to centimeters. That is 4 meters, 55 centimeter to centimeter. We have 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So we write 4 meters in terms of 4 into 100, that is 400 centimeters. But what about 55 centimeters? Yes, we shall add them with 400. So 400 plus 55 results to 455 centimeters. So to change meter and centimeter to centimeter, we multiply them by 100 and then add the centimeter. Let us see for kilometers to meters. Mr. Raj traveled 13 kilometers from point A to B. What would be the distance in meters? Yes, we know that 1 kilometer is equals to 1000 meters. So, in order to convert this, we take 13 multiplied by 1000. That results to 13,000 meters. Therefore, Mr. Raj traveled 13,000 meters to reach from point A to point B. So, to change kilometers to meters, we multiply by 1000. The same way, if we have to convert kilometers and meters to meters, we have, for example, 3 kilometers, 239 meters. That is 3 to be converted to meters by multiplying by 1000, 3000. Exactly as we did in the earlier, we will be adding the remaining part of it, that is 239 with 3000. So it would be 3,239 meters. We have 3 kilometers, 239 meters as 3,239 meters. So to change kilometers and meters to meters, we multiply kilometer by 1000 and then add the meters. So in this way, we have learned today about the length and how to convert the units of length from one to another. So we shall meet in the next class. Till then, take care. Goodbye.